Alice Birtle here from lesrib.com. I just wanted to show you the briquettes that we make to burn on the fire. This is one of our briquettes. As you can see, it's a square shape, but they can be any shape you like. We just made it this shape because we had some plywood left over from another job, and so that's what we made it with. The only thing that is important is that whatever shape you have, that you have a hole through the middle of your briquette, because that helps in the combustion of them when you put them on the fire. Our briquettes are actually made of a mixture of cardboard and paper that we tear up. It can be any sort of cardboard, loo roll middles, anything you like, which we tear up until we get pieces like this. And because we do a lot of woodworking, we always have an ample supply of sawdust. And these two combined actually make the briquettes eventually. The next step is that we soak the cardboard and sawdust in water for 2 to 3 days, at which point you're then ready to make your briquettes. Okay, so this is our briquette maker. It's the second one we've made. Very simple construction, which I'm sure most people could manage. Basically, it's some big chunks of wood bolted together just here and bolted to the feet at the bottom. We then attached a car jack. So the next stage is, after you've soaked your cardboard, torn up cardboard, and the sawdust for a couple of days, you need to mix them together. Well, the way we do it is to put some of the cardboard in a bucket, spray it liberally with water, and then you really need something that's going to mash it up a bit more and macerate it. We use a drill with an old saw blade to mash everything up. Wouldn't really recommend this, as I'm sure you can find tools that are made specially for the job, but this is what we do. Okay, so when you've added the sawdust, you can just give it a final mix. You can use the drill attachment just to make sure it's all well amalgamated. You don't have to use sawdust, you can use really leaves or anything that actually can be composted, you can use to make the briquettes. Okay. I've just added a little bit more water, because what you definitely want to make sure is that you have a nice sloppy mixture, because that makes it easier when you put it into the form to make your briquettes. So I'll just show you what we use to actually make our briquettes before I actually do it. We've got a base which has got a long metally screw thingy on there, just because that's what we had lying around. We have a metal pipe which has got holes drilled in, don't know if you can see that, so that as you press the briquette, the water can escape somewhere. This goes onto the metal pipe. We then have our box, our form that actually makes the briquettes. That goes over there. We then put some of the mixture down to there. When we've got about halfway, we put a divider in, that goes next, then more of the mixture, then another one of these on top, and then this actually sits on top there, and this is the bit that it all gets pressed. So you put your mix in to however many you decide you want. Put your divider in. I usually give this a little squeeze just to get a little bit of the moisture out. So you position your form on top of the jack and start pumping. Right, so this is how we get the briquettes out of the form. You tip the whole thing over, watching out for any water that's going to come out. Take the base off and push. And there you have a briquette. So this needs to be dried now, obviously depending on the time of the year and where you live, until it is completely dry. So we've built a rack to actually put our briquettes on once we've made them. So this is the rack we built to dry our briquettes. Again, nothing fancy in the woodwork. We just used some old scrap wood and some wire, which we've stapled onto this little frame here. So that's the first six I've made. We'll just leave them here to dry. But I better get on and make the next lot.